This hub is sitting on 20 acres of land at Lira University. Stone cutting, shoemaking, tailoring, coffee and maize processing, welding and hairdressing are among the skills that will be taught here. The State House Controller Jane Bareche has been moving across the country to assess progress of infrastructure development and provide guidance on the operation of the hubs. Lira is her most recent stop. The 20 presidential industrial hubs across the country are set to train disadvantaged youth in different disciplines to help them access resources to improve their livelihoods. This initiative by President Museveni targets young adults who dropped out of school for reasons beyond their control. Bareche has given the leaders 1 month to come up with a structure to manage the hub in Lira and start the selection process.
Don't look at education background. Any capable person who can be skilled, who has two hands, is supposed to be selected, comes in here, gets a skill, goes out there and apply it to generate some income out of it. You're going to choose a youth who has a will, come and be.
Each of the 10 districts in the region will nominate 6 people to help in the selection of beneficiaries, and they will have a representative on the 10-member committee to manage the hub. Bareche emphasizes that only disadvantaged Ugandans should be selected.
I'm going to choose a Ugandan who is disadvantaged. I'm not going to choose someone because he's your relative. I'm not going to choose someone because he belongs to some political group. No, we are going to choose a Ugandan who is disadvantaged economically. We are not going to look at any other issue. Not your relative, not from a member of parliament. He has given you 10 people, so this one are going to be taken because they voted me. No, this is for all Ugandans belonging to each, from each background.
The State House official says the hub will train 300 people per semester twice a year.
The institution here is going to carry 300 people per semester. If all the skills are captured, so if all our districts can get out 300 beneficiaries per semester, I really think in the long run everyone is going to benefit.
She gave the Lango leaders 1 month to prepare, as government also put in place missing gaps before the skilling starts.
There, get people to learn. We intend to give you like 1 month. By 1 month, you respond to us with lists. And then we also are going to prepare and do other things that you've seen, but are not yet complete, so that at least in that length of time, we can begin. I came with a suggestion that you choose a team of 10 people. Why do I need by 10 people? Because you're 10 districts.
Local leaders took this opportunity to ask the president to handle critical issues like roads and political appointments in Lango.
Carry them and ask the principal to help us work on them. The one on roads, those are not jokes. They are very serious issues in this region. And the discussions must be carried out very candidly. It's not going to be the usual statement that you've just started. No, we now think we are there. So it's a lot about when did we start. Even the Bible says those who came last will be first. So we deserve to be where we are at this time.
Lango sub-region has 9 districts, including Lira, Apach, Oyam, Kole, Dokolo, Alebtong, Otuke, and Amolatar. This report was compiled by Hudson Apunyo for the news.